Let me show you how to embed the voice agent version of your agent from Jotform on this video. So follow me to my desktop right now. Welcome to Jotform. My name is George, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to embed the voice version of your AI agent on WordPress, Wix, or any other site that lets you embed via HTML. Okay, so let's get started. This is my Jotform workspace, and if you are located here, you'll be able to find all your Jotform creations right here. So forms, tables, agents, etc. All right, so in this case, we're going to go straight to the agents. So let's click on my workspace. Let's go to my agents. And in this section, we're going to select the agent that we want to embed on our websites. Now, in this case, you can go ahead and create a brand new agent or select from the ones that you have created previously. So in this case, I'm going to use this one, which is the school administrator, just for testing purposes. So I am going to select it and I'm going to go to edit agent. Now, in order for us to embed this on a website, we need to go into the publish tab. And in the publish tab, you'll be able to find several versions available. In this case, if you want to embed the voice version, go ahead and select it right here, voice agent. This is going to start the voice agent by default when you embed it. So this is the best option for you, okay? So here we go. We have several options available. We can go ahead and share the link. We can share it via QR code, direct to social media, or embed it on a website, which is what we're going to do on this video. So we have the page embed option, which is the first one that I'm going to show you. In this case, I can go ahead and preview this before I actually embed it. The reason for this is we want to make sure that everything is looking the way we want it in order for it to get embedded on our website. So this is a test version. We are good to go. So I like the preview. Now I am going to customize it. Now you have several options for customization from the beginning when you go ahead and go into the builder, and a few options available right here. So we can set the width to 100% or set it to a different setting. So we can change it to 50%, 70%, or do it by pixel by selecting it right here. We can also change the height. In this case, it's set by height, and we can also do percentage if we want. We can remove the background, and this would be a good idea if you're gonna embed it on a website, because you might already have a background there, or you might set a different background on the website and not from the one available on Jotform. So I would recommend that you turn it off, but it's up to you, okay? And then we have the shadow. So there's a little shadow going on right here. We can also remove this, but in this case, I do like that effect, so I'm gonna leave it on, okay? So we're good to go. Let's go ahead and save this. And when we save it, this code is going to update. So I do recommend that you customize first and then grab the code, okay? So we're good to go. We are gonna embed the voice version with the page embed. So let's go ahead and copy the code. And we're gonna do this on WordPress to get started. So in this case, we are in WordPress and we want to add it to a page, okay? So we're gonna go into pages, and in pages, we can embed it on a page that we've previously created, or we can just go ahead and create a brand new page just for testing purposes, okay? In this case, I'm gonna name it voice agent, okay? And I'm going to add a brand new block right here. Now, in this case, I am using the default builder from WordPress, which is Gutenberg. But if you have a different theme builder like Elementor, Divi, Beaver Builder, etc., they will all have an option that says HTML, okay? In different sections, it might say code, HTML, embed code, etc., but it's same concept, okay? So with Gutenberg, it's going to say custom HTML. So I'm going to select this, and I'm going to paste the code that I just grabbed on Jotform, okay? So let's go ahead and publish this. Here we go. Let's go ahead and preview this page, and we should see the voice agent pop up, okay? Here we go. There is no background, as you could see, because I turned that off in the code that we just grabbed, okay? So we now have a voice agent here on our website. Here we go. It's going to kick it off right now.
Hi there. It's great to hear your voice. How can I assist you with the school registration today?
There we go. We now have this available on the live site. That's our own site. So that's one of the ways that you can embed this on a WordPress site. Now that's for the page embed. Now let's go ahead and also do the page embed on a Wix site. So if you are using a Wix website builder, go ahead and edit your site. So let's go ahead and jump into the editor version of the Wix so we can embed this voice agent. And let's give it a few seconds for this to load up, and then we're going to edit it. Okay, here we go. We now have the Wix builder available, and we want to embed our voice agent in a section of our website. In this case, I'm going to use this page, but we can also create a standalone page just for the voice agent. But in this case, I'm gonna add it straight here, okay? So we're gonna add a brand new section. Here we go, and we are going to add an element. And that element, we're gonna type in here HTML, and we have this option, embed code. So we're gonna select the embed code, we're gonna click on the plus button, and it's gonna add it right here. Now we need to add the code again, the code that we grabbed from Jotform. We're gonna click on enter code, we're gonna paste that code, let's go ahead and remove this, and we're gonna paste the code that we grabbed from Jotform, okay? Let's go ahead and update this. Here we go, and in a few seconds, we should be able to view the voice version of our agent. So let's go ahead and stretch this. Here we go. And here we go. Okay, so it's now inside of this section of a Wix site. So in this case, I go ahead and click on publish, and that should now be available on our Wix website. That's our own website in this case, and we have the voice agent available there. So clients can start using it, okay? So if I go ahead and click on talk to Ada, it will kick off just like it would normally. So that's one of the ways that you're gonna embed this on a Wix website, okay? Now, let's go back into Jotform, and we have a different setting available. There's also the chat bot. So that means that we can have a pop-up bubble on our website where we have the voice agent, okay? So again, I would recommend that you preview this just so you make sure that this is what you want to use, and then we go ahead and add it to the site. So now we have this pop-up on the bottom, which is the voice agent. And you get to hear, it's now available for us to start chatting with Ada in this case. So here we go, we're gonna go ahead and customize this too. So again, we have some customization settings that I would recommend that you tweak first before you add it to your website. So we have the greeting, which is how can I assist you? And that greeting is this one right here. So if you want to change it, go ahead and do so right here, right? We also have that pulsing option, which is going to kind of pulse. You can see here, kind of there, it's like a little light pulse where it's just gonna make the viewers check it out. So, oh, there's that little bubble in the corner because it's pulsing. So something is moving. So if you want to keep that on, go ahead and take it on, okay? You can also open by default. So in the preview, you saw that I previewed it and it automatically opened up the voice agent. That is an option. You can also do always open. So there's no option to turn to make it in a bubble. And there's also the option for after 5 seconds or after 10 seconds, which is a good idea. If someone sticks around for more than 10 seconds, then you show them that pop-up, which could be a good idea. But if you don't want to annoy your clients, your fans, your customers, etc., go ahead and do not open automatically. So that means that someone has to click on that bubble in order for it to open. So in this case, I'm gonna do not open, right? And then you have the position option, okay? So you want it to the right or to the left. In this case, we're gonna keep it to the right, and let's go ahead and save this. Here we go, and now we have this code. So let's go ahead and copy this code, and let's go into our WordPress site, all right? So in this case, since this is a pop-up bubble that we want to use on all of the website and not just in a specific page, well, we want to add this in a different section. So in WordPress, what we're going to do, we are going to go into tools and we're going to go into theme file editor. So this will edit a section of the whole website, okay? So be aware that if this is a kind of a warning, so be aware that not to remove any code in this section because that could potentially change the look of your site, okay? So what we want to do is find the header option here on the WordPress site, and we are going to add it at the end in this case, okay? So let's go ahead and update this file. Here we go. It should be successful in a few seconds, and there it is. It is now successful. So now let's go into the website. So let's go into the main site, and we're going to open it up right here. This is just a demo site, so nothing fancy going on, but we have the bubble available there for our voice agent. So you can see here that it says, hi, how can I assist you? Because that's the message that we have set up on Jotform, and it's not opening automatically because the way we set it up is that we have to click on it in order for it to kick off. So in this case, we now have the voice agent available here on the WordPress site, and this will be available in every single page of our website. So if I go to this sample page, we got it there. If I go to the voice agent page, this will be kind of redundant because I've already have it embedded here, but we have it available there. So you can see here, it's now available on every single page because we added the code in the header section. Now, again, I have to give you that warning. Be aware not to modify any other aspect of the code, just the one you've added it right here, okay? So that's one of the ways that you can do it. Now, to add the bubble on a Wix website, things will be a bit different since depending on the plan you are on, you'll be able to add the code on the entire site or not. In this case, I have the basic version. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into the last element right here and we are going to add a code, okay? So again, we're gonna add an embed code. Let's click on the plus button and we should see it available here, okay? Now let's go ahead and enter the code, the one we grabbed on Jotform. We're gonna paste it in and we're gonna update it right here, okay? So now we have the script available here, okay? So let's go ahead and move that a little bit to the top. Here we go. And now we're going to have the bubble on this particular page. Now, this method will make you add the bubble to each one of the pages that you've created. It's a workaround, but it still works, okay? You got that option available there, okay? So let's go back into Jotform. The next option we have is the WordPress version. Now, this is a dedicated WordPress method. In order for this to work, we need to use the Jotform WordPress plugin. And we're gonna grab this embed code. So you activate the plugin, and once you add this code, any section of the website, that will work, okay? The next option I wanna show you is the Lightbox option. So let's go ahead and select this. And again, we're gonna go ahead and preview this before we actually use it. So here we go, here's the Lightbox. We're gonna select it and it's gonna open up this section. So it works in a different method. So it's like a button and then it's gonna pop up the Lightbox, okay? So in order for this to work, we're gonna go ahead and copy this code. We're gonna go into our WordPress side. Here we go, let's go into pages. Let's go ahead and use this one, the voice agent one that we've created previously. Let's go ahead and remove this and we are going to add the HTML one. So custom HTML, let's go ahead and paste it in. Let's go ahead and save it. Here we go. Let's go ahead and preview this and we should see our voice agent button right here. So here we go, school administrator AI agent. So let's go ahead and select it and it will open up the Lightbox. And here we go, we got the voice agent available. Now there's an option that you can modify this, but this will have to be done manually as of now. So as of this video. So right now there is no editing option for this, but if we go to the code that we've just pasted in, we can change a few things. For example, we can change the color of the button and we can change the message of the button. So for example, right here. So here's the message on the button that you just saw. So let's go ahead and check that out. Here it is. It says school administrator. We can change this here manually. So I can go ahead and remove something from here and leave it like that and it will update over there. And there's also the colors. You got background color, the border color. So you will need the hex color in order for this to update. Okay, so you got all of the available colors here and the sizes, but you will have to do this manually just so you have an idea how to change it, okay? So that will have to be done manually, but that's another option that you have, okay? Now in Wix, this is how we're going to do it. Let's go into our website right here, and we are gonna go ahead and add it just about right here, okay? So let's go into the plus button. We're gonna add the embed code, and I'm gonna add it right here. So I'm gonna enter that code, and I'm gonna paste it in, and I'm gonna update it, and we are gonna have that button right here. So now I have this button available that I can add it in different sections of the website. And if they click on it, it's going to open up the Lightbox in order for us to kick in that voice agent, okay? So let's go ahead and remove this. Just a super easy way to add the voice agent via Lightbox. The next option is the pop-up option, okay? So let's go ahead and preview this. Here we go, let's click on it and we have a pop-up. So it's now in a different page that's gonna pop up, but we have the voice agent in a different section, okay? So that's a different method. Let's go ahead and copy this code. Let's go ahead and test it out on WordPress. So let's replace this code right here, paste it in, let's go ahead and save it, and let's go ahead and preview it right now. So now we have this button, and again, if we click on it, it's not going to be the Lightbox. It's now going to be a pop-up. So let's go ahead and select it, and we have a pop-up of the voice agent, okay? So it's a really great method here. And again, if we want to modify that button, we can do so here manually on the script, okay? Now for the Wix side, let's go into the editor right here. Let's go ahead and add that code right here. So let's add the embed code. Let's go ahead and enter that code. It's gonna paste it in, update, and it's gonna add that button for us to click, and it's going to open up the pop-up instead of the Lightbox. So several options available to embed your voice version agent on your website. So definitely check these options out and don't forget to select the voice agent to make the default one that's gonna show on your website. And if you wanna make a default one, the phone agent, the chatbot agent standalone, go ahead and select these in order for these to be embedded. But this is for the voice agent. So I hope you like this video, and please let us know here in the comments what you think about the embed option and what you would like to see in the future in terms of features. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.